કચરાનો અંબા હેલ્થ સેન્ટર તરફથી જાહેરાત છે કે કોઈને મેડિકલ ઇમરજન્સી હોય તો આ નંબર પર એટલે કે 9944444 પર કરે સંપર્ક કરે. ખાસ હાલ આ નંબર માત્ર ઇમરજન્સી માટે છે. જો ઇમરજન્સી ના હોય તો નીચે રિસેપ્શનના નંબર પર ફોન કરો. જય સચિદાનંદ.
So the satsang is about to start. Parayan Aptavani 7, August 27th in India. Morning session. We have just begun, we just began reading Chapter 15, which says Ways to Heal Pain and Your Own Balance Sheet, was the first heading. As we see our Gnani come to Lord Simandhar, oh my Lord, in the presence of Lord, the Gnani Purush Dada Shri, my highest namaskars to you. In presence of Dada Bhagwan, as my witness, my highest namaskars to you. And, O Lord Krishna, in the presence of Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self within me, my highest namaskars to you. In the living presence of the Absolute Self within me, my highest namaskars to you. And Lord Shiva, to everyone who is the embodiment of salvation of the others, in the live presence of the Absolute Self within, my highest namaskars to you, my Lord. Pratyaksh Dada Bhagwani Sakshi Shri Shri Swarupne Namaskar Karuchu. And to our Gnani Purush Dada Shri, oh eternal Gnani of Akram Vignan, our highest namaskars to you. As the Gnani walks over to the celestial being, Ma Padmavati Devi, Ma Padmavati, in the live presence of the Absolute Self, Dada Bhagwan, my highest namaskars to you, O Ma. Please accept our namaskars. And to Pujaniru Ma, in the live presence of Dada Bhagwan, O Niru Ma, our highest namaskars. To you, please accept our love and namaskars. And to Ma Amba, in the live presence of Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self, please accept our namaskars, O Ma, O Mother. And as soon as he sits down, I will take away the sound of the Dada Bhagwan Nasinji Jikar Ho as the Gnani turns to the thousands who are sitting, absorbing this magnificent revival and energization of the words of Gnani Purush Dada Shri from Aptavani 3 and 7. 3, we had 4 days. This is the second day of Aptavani 7 now. The middle section is of the young men and women in white who have dedicated their life to the cause of Akram Vignan and serving the current Gnani according to his wishes for Jagat Kalyan. And so the Gnani now takes a seat. As we begin our Parayan, and as we read the words of our Gnani Purush, we are asking for the energy to receive them as they are without any use of our intellect, and let the Prajna, the awakened energy within us, absorb it all for the purposes of our own liberation only and nothing else. So misery is for the one who takes it upon himself, is the heading. bossing around those below us means to have a an air, attitude, and a stance of superiority that I am somebody, and there is the arrogance of the ego that is associated with it. We boss around those below us. As the Gnani now opens the Aptavanis. Hello. Jai Sachidanand, highest, I bow to the Absolute Self, the Paramatma who resides within you with a deep sense of oneness and continued sense of obeisance and namaskars. Jai Sachidanand. Everybody's bliss is growing, no? Yes. Yes, as the understanding increases, the bliss also increases. These are magnificent talks. Only to remain as the self, and you say, what happens when your pocket gets picked? The pain, rather than misery, pain is for the one who takes it upon himself. Instead of the word misery, use the word pain in this heading. Question. Page 195 in Gujaratri. Questioner, I work in the day-to-day life and we boss around those below us. Friction with people in the factory. This gives rise to reactions within that person as well as me. In this, am I not liable if I am not able to appease the other person and heal his reactions? Dada Shri, the inner intent does not change for you, so then you do not have a problem. Your bhav doesn't change. Questioner, but what about the reaction that happens within the other person caused by my action and speech? Dada Shri says, what I am saying is that it applies to you if you are the doer, and it does not apply to you if you are not the doer. But should everyone not feel good with my action, Dada? No, it is nothing like that at all. What would you do if someone does not like your grey hair? How is it your fault if he gets irritated by seeing your grey hair? This is a very subtle talk. Not everyone can understand this. But what do people say if you hurt someone, that you will incur liability of a fault? Hey, when does the other person not have inner turmoil or a jumpo? Somebody or the other is in inner turmoil, is it not? You, as the self, as the Rhinocele, in your awareness, never give anyone any pain. It is just your belief that you are hurting the other person. See, if you say, sir, come and have your dinner, he'll say, I have my dinner at 12 every day and you're calling me at 11:30. So you never know when he will be in pain. When does he not have the causes for being in pain? Those causes of pain are always there. What can you do if he's irritated seeing your grey hair? So, what do we say, the Gnani? You are not liable because you, Y-capital, are not the doer. As long as you are the doer, as Uwe or Katyanada, as long as you believe I am Uwe, I am Chandubhai, you are liable. Questioner. So then how can Goshado, the disciple of Lord Mahavir, be hurt by Lord Mahavir at all? Goshada was hurt because he followed a completely opposite path from the Lord. Did he not? Dada Shri says, Goshada used to be in a lot of pain because of Lord Mahavir. He used to feel, because of Mahavir's presence, my reputation is in ruin. So it would be nice if he wasn't around. He says, because of Mahavir, my reputation, my pride is... not is his own pride was hurting him. So what does Lord Mahavir say? It is pain that he has taken upon himself. I have not given it to him. Just as a monk goes around begging for food and drink, in the same way one goes and begs for pain. So what can anyone do about the pain one begs for? Lord Mahavir says, for such pain that he has taken upon himself, what can I do? Lord Mahavir's presence caused Goshada a lot of pain. Lord Mahavir was aware that poor Goshada is in pain, and it is out of pain that he says, Lord Mahavir is like this and he is like that. Because of his own pain, because of his jealousy, because of his inability to get the same kind of credit that the Lord was getting. So therefore he will enter into negativity. It was his the hunger for pride that was really hurting him. His kashai was hurting him. His own kashais were hurting him. Nobody else was giving him the pain. What can the Lord do? The Lord was Vitarag. He says, it is not my pain that I am giving you. It has arisen because of his own kashais. Should he start fasting? But the Lord says, this pain, he has begged for it himself. I have not given it to him. There is a lot of difference between pain given to you by someone and the pain you bring upon yourself or you beg for. Please explain that, Dada. Dada Shri. Now let's look at the other side of the coin. The Lord is not giving the pain, however, the person still takes on the pain. But are we getting hurt by somebody else? The other person is not giving it to us, but we get hurt by the other person. He is just saying something, but he is just saying the subatomic particles in the air, but you know, you think they are, you taking it. This is the fault is of the sufferer. This is not, you don't have to say the fault is the sufferer by accusing somebody that you are suffering because of a fault. This is for our own self only. If you accept that, then you will be in pain. If somebody is in pain, you should not say, oh, what do I do with his pain? And no matter what somebody does, you know, is there any pain arising for you within? And if it does, then we have begged it for ourselves. We have taken it upon ourselves. If we do not beg for it, nobody can give us any pain whatsoever. Vahru means, you know, you cup your hands and say, please give it to me, like a beggar does. Please give me some food. And so, if I don't take on any pain, do not beg for any pain, then how can I get any pain? This is the science of Dada. The Siddhant means that which works from all angles, from that which has got solutions from all angles. If we serve, now let us talk about it. Let's look at the other side of the coin, says Sanjay. If you are not the doer, then you are not responsible at all. So it is all dependent upon the sense of doership. Am I in the state of doership? But if I only have the conviction that I am that I am pure soul, and if I do not have enough experience, will I be liable? No, it is all dependent, says Deepak Bhai, upon your state of doership. If you are the doer, if you believe that I did it, then there is pain for you, but otherwise you are not giving the pain. The experience means, yes, there is a conviction that I am not the doer, but then there is awareness that it belongs to Uwe, not to me. And then there is the experience that experience means, along with all the qualities of the self, one is absolutely in the state of the self only and is not at all concerned with any qualities of the non-self or the Pudgal or any fights of the Pudgal, or no matter what is happening in the non-self, it doesn't affect him. But you see, I am beyond pain. I am Avyabhadha Swarup. Nobody can hurt me. That is coming to you. It comes into your experience. He is able to say, and then, you know, if your foot crushes an insect, then he knows that I am not this foot. Therefore, why do you say that I killed that insect? You see? But as long as the intellect and the ego still says that I killed the insect, then ask him to do the pratikraman. But if you don't have any sense that I did anything in terms of killing the insect, then of course, then you don't need to do pratikraman, do you? But you see, just as I cannot give him pain, in the same way, he cannot give me pain. Nobody can hurt him. That is the experience. I am avyabhad. In the same way, the other person is also beyond pain. These are all the resultant effects of pudgal to pudgal only. But you see, if somebody else is hurting you, then it means that there pratikraman is necessary because the effect is coming to you. But if you nobody can hurt you at all, then you know that nobody can touch you in any way. But you know, if nobody is hurting me, then I cannot be hurting anyone. That is the way it is. And have I taken any pain from somebody? In other words, am I begging some pain from somebody? Means, the meaning of begging pain from somebody means is, do I accept the effects of anything that happens from someone, as nimit, that consider as pain within me? If I consider it as pain within me, then I have begged for that pain. He is not giving it to. If somebody is getting respected and you are not being respected, immediately you feel disrespected or you feel less respected, you feel slighted, or you know, then you go and start talking negatively about this person or that person, and you are, and all wrong, you are actually playing in pain only, and that which causes pain. If you are just everywhere, pain will not happen. If you avoid clashes, there will be no pain. If you accept whatever happens is justice, there is no pain. If you say fault is of the sufferer, then there is no pain at all. But you know, if I say that fault is, but you know, if I use this supportive AAEB things, will the other person not be hurt through something by that by me? The one who does not have any drop of pain to anyone. If you are a beggar, but you have a lot of pain around you. You are wealthy with reference to pain, and you are constantly giving the pain to others. Whereas, if you do not have any, this is a very beautiful sentence that. Because what she says, nobody gives me any pain because I never beg for pain. What can I do? This is a very good thing. You see, Lord, it is pain that I have not given it to him. So Lord Mahavir's sentence is excellent. So what can anyone do about pain that one begs for, you see? So this is a beautiful understanding of Lord Mahavir that you see, you know, what the world considers as painful, I do not consider it as pain at all because I do not take any pain. This is a very high level of understanding. If we understand, if we get the understanding that nobody is really hurting me, I am the one who is begging for it, I am the one who is taking it upon himself, then, of course, nobody is hurting me. So this is the second step, you see. Second step. First, stop. You should never hurt anyone, of course. That now, nobody can do anything that is going to affect me because I am not Uve, I am not Nada, I am not Kachya, I am not Shuddha. You see, I am the pure, blissful one. You see, so where I am, there is no one can touch me with reference to any kind of pain. You see, I am beyond pain. So without changing anything, you can remain in the continuous bliss of the self. You see, this is magnificent stuff and talk. But if I am in the sense that I am this body, and also I may have the awareness that I am pure soul, when I am, but on that basis, will I be hurting somebody? It is of course there, because the moment, yes, will I be hurting others? Yeah, people do not like your white hair. So, but you see, if the people do not like your white hair, they take the pain upon themselves. But you are not giving any pain, right? No, but you know, your attitude should not be indifferent and crass in saying that he is taking the pain upon himself. But if you do not take on any pain yourself, then only for 3 years, then only you have the right to say that I am avyabhadha, I am beyond pain, I do not give pain to anyone. But you see, but first of all, right now, let us understand and let us not beg for any pain ourselves. Let us not take on any more pain ourselves. This requires a tremendous awareness. No, it is not a tremendous awareness. It requires only the right understanding, says Deepak Bhai. But if somebody asks somebody to do some work for you from somebody who is in your department, will you get upset? That means I have taken on the pain, says Sanjay. So Deepak Bhai just kind of did a little minor operation for Sanjay, because he feels that he is in control of his department, and without his authority and understanding, nobody should be doing anything. Deepak Bhai, you have climbed so many steps. But you know, now, whatever we have the magnificent work of talk of Dada in front of us, so don't worry about me. Here we have the words of Dada, let us focus on that. And if you know that you do not give any pain to anyone, there is no human being who can touch me or give me pain. And I really cannot, I am not giving pain to anyone. I do not, I am avyabhadha. You see? Yes, has it come to you? He says, I have got a feeling that it is happening to me, says Deepak Bhai. I don't hurt anyone and I don't take anybody's pain upon myself. I am separate from Deepak. Deepak is separate, I am separate. And that is the same principle that we need to apply. That is the same essential knowledge that we need to apply with reference to Uve is separate, Katya is separate, Nara is separate, and I am the blissful one. That is all. And as you catch that, I don't want to see anybody's faults is number one, and I do not want to hurt anyone. When you stop seeing faults of others and you don't stop hurting others, then the result will be that, you know, you will stop. Nothing will affect you in this world. And of course, these are all on the basis of this Dada Vani, the words of Dada Shri. This is a fantastic thing. You see, when we say the soul is avyabhadha, beyond pain, but now we are getting the practical aspect of it. We are getting the practical aspects of how you or I really, as Mahatmas, can never hurt anyone, nor is anyone hurting us. We are taking on the pain. We are begging for this pain. We are grabbing it and smearing it upon us, and we say that I'm in pain or that person hurt me, etc. But you see, this is a very practical approach, and so the words are there, but you see, now the words will lead you to the experience, and once the experience comes, and therefore then it comes in vyavahar, in the worldly interaction. Because everybody is avyabhadha, everybody is such. On page 6, 26, page 31. Now if I am hurting somebody, then it is my ego only. If the belief that I am hurting somebody, it is my own sense of sensitiveness. You see, I really do not hurt anyone. It is on my super sensitivity that makes me believe that I am hurting other people. Really, it is the I is belonging to the soul only. There is no other I. The sense that I am Uve or I am this body, that is the whole problem. And in this, there is the sense that, oh, I am hurting somebody. You are not hurting anybody. And on the second part, the other part or side of the coin is that, am I taking on somebody's pain? Varilavu, varilavu. That means I am taking on somebody's pain. You see. You know, somebody might put 15 different types of sweets and desserts in front of you. But if you say that, no, I am not hungry today, I will not take anything, then can he make you feed, can he force you to have those sweets at all? In the same way, somebody might have all kinds of negative dishes in front of you, painful dishes, and if you do not take it, then will you be suffering? You can say, no, I am not going to take it in. Yes, let us come down from this step. But on the other hand, you can say, by going down one step, by telling Deepak and say, Deepak, make sure that you, through your nimitta, are not hurting anyone. Let us now read further, because there is very beautiful stuff in here. We were talking last night with Dimpal Bhai. Dada says our Vignan is a self-operating Kriyakari autopilot. Sanjay is putting his own spin on some of these things here. By clearing up level, Dada has, and Deepak has just given us an exact answer here, so I'm not translating his question. He says, if I try to get this stage, what has been explained, then it will not happen. He says, if you say that you are never in university, but at least study when you are at the university, that is all. Otherwise, you know, even if you are at the university and if you don't study, who will accept that you are at the university? You have to attend classes, you know. So you have to finish your first level of college wherein you stop hurting other people. And you see, then you are sincere with reference to. But in the sense, by stopping hurting other people, in other words, you are not hurting, but you should be aware that Uwe is hurting, and that is where the hurt has to be stopped or turned around, you see. Sincerity is very critical, says Deepak Bhai. Okay. Now, this is very beautiful stuff. This is one of the most magnificent top key, says Deepak Bhai, which is very practical and practically applicable. Bless me that I will get it, says Sanjay. No. Okay, so you are a good student. That is why you are sitting in the front, you see. It's only the... I am a dud. I am not a bright student. Just because I am sitting up front doesn't mean that I am bright, says Sanjay. Okay. Everybody has... Yes. The people in the back, do they understand that? That is why I have to make these people stand and sit in the front, says Deepak Bhai. I used to sit in the back only, but now I never used to sit in the front. I never used to get to sit in front of Dada. I would sit in the back corner and I was focused on the Dada Vada. I would listen to the words and I would try to figure out what Dada was saying. People who sit in the back, they will great benefit, says Deepak Bhai. And people in the back are all clapping. All right, so you don't get special privilege. And then Deepak Bhai is saying to Sanjay, now don't go back all the way just because I have said. For you, it's okay for you to sit here. All right. Okay. Yeah. Let us read forward. Please explain that. Dadashri, what does pain that has been back pain, that has been back mean? Says Sanjay. See, the other person is taking on. Now, you're not giving the pain, but the other one is taking it on. In the same example, again, the other person is not giving it, but you are taking it on. The other, she says, say you take your lunch at 12:30 every day, and one day the lunch gets ready early, so you're called. Chandubhai, Uwe, come and eat, the food is ready. Come along, why are you sitting around? So you say, I do not eat just yet. Why do you bother me right now? So the pain that happens in you is what you have created, invited, begged. And he did not come to give you pain. All he is saying is, sir, come and give Uwe. Come on and have a meal. So what about the desire to make the other person happy, Dada? Why, Dada, she says, why do you have to harbor the desire for pleasure and happiness of the other person? Dada, she is saying, when this is a very critical. You see, he was trying to say something, but Dada gave it the wrong. But why do I want to please the other person? And Dada Shri says, why do you want to harbor the desire for pleasure and happiness of the other person? When you say it would be nice if the other person is happy, does that mean that you are the giver of pleasure and happiness? Are you the giver of pleasure and happiness to others? Dada Shri, questioner. And what about jealousy? What about when jealousy arises from seeing the pleasure of someone, Dada? This is also another siddhant. It's an incontrovertible principle. Just as you really cannot hurt anyone, in the same way you cannot give pleasure to anyone. You really are not giving any pleasure to anyone. It is the body that is giving the pleasure, right? Okay, right. Questioner, and what about jealousy that arises by seeing the pleasure of someone? Is that also pain that has been begged and invited? Varili delu. And the other Shri says, jealousy is pain that has been begged. All irsha, jealousy, competitiveness, competitiveness, you see, envy, all these pains are begged pains only. There is no such thing as pain, in fact, says Dada. No one causes me any pain because we do not beg for any pain. Otherwise, the pain will come. One will keep on stumbling and the world will keep on talking for sure. As long as all this will go on for sure, but pain is for the one who begs for it. This is, you see, no, this is a very big sentence, says that the same thing. Dada Shri says that I, after my enlightenment in 1958, no, there is no one around who gives me pain, and I do not give any pain to anyone. It was my misunderstanding before the Gnan that I was hurting anyone. Just as we apply that in worldly interactions, we also, it is the end of Tattva Gnan, the elemental knowledge, that as the elements that we are, the souls that we are, the rhinoceros that we are, we really are, we are not giving any pain. So get rid of this idea that I'm hurting somebody or somebody is hurting me. You see, how can a soul hurt a soul? You see, the question is that the belief that I am a body is the reason why you hurt each other. You see, it is the ignorance and the ego. Because of ignorance, the ego arises and the ego says, oh, he hurt me, she hit, I hurt her, she hit me, she hurt me, I hit her, etc. So, you see, the ego is hurting each other and the ego is also doing pratikraman for all of this. But the Atma can never hurt another Atma. Dada's ego was completely gone. Therefore, he became the embodiment of the soul and the self only, Atma Roop. And therefore, he is sharing all of this with his. You see, my own anger, pride, deceit and greed were the reason why I felt that made me feel that I was being hurt. But once my kasha is the anger, pride, deceit and greed that go away, then nobody is giving me. Other people are actually, when they're hurting me, they are actually benevolent for me because they make me understand who am I. It is only when you understand who you really are at the main level, at the Shuddhatma level, then this, all of this, you become free from pain in the real way. There is, for countless lifetimes, nobody has hurt me, says Dada. Now, questioner, and the one who gives the pain, he is sowing new seed of karma, is he not? Dada Shri says, you should not be concerned with that. That is how the world is and that is how it runs. The world is with pleasure, pain, sukh, dukh. And the give-take is naimitik bhav, through evidences only. You see, it is actually through the bhav of the nimit only, you see, that I am hurting, I am helping, etc. Actually, it is really nothing but the accounts being settled only from a previous life. If you give 500,000 in a previous life to somebody, then the result is that the karma of one has to give and the other one has to take. Once karma of giving is finished and the other person's of taking is finished, you see. And so the activity is already happening. So the give and take of Vyavahar is really the effect of the non-self complexes. And you see, therefore, in every karma, one really gives, unfolds its effects and goes away. We do not know whether our karma is to take the money or to give the money, you see, in effect. Because we do not know the total spectrum of the cause and effect, we make a lot of noise when our money is not being returned to us. But really, if he doesn't return our money, this is an effect from a previous cause in the previous life, you see. So it is everything. It's a nimit and naimitik. It is through a nimit, there is a naimitik. There are only two nimits. One is giving, the other one is taking. One is helping, the other one is hurting, etc. And we are the simple, blissful knowers of it, never involved in it after the entry into Akramvignan, you see. And so if it is not in my unfolding karma to receive money, no matter whether it was my own money that I gave him till the last moment in this body, I will not get the money back, you see. And but by doing rag dvesh about it, by doing dvesh effects, you are carrying it on further in the next life. But it is all happening, this cycle of pleasure, pain, give, take, helping, hurting, etc. is continuously happening within the two non-self complexes, the pudgal, one pudgal with the other, or multiple pudgals with other multiple pudgals, only the non-self complexes. You see, now this knowledge that we have right in front of us is pushing us towards moksha. Next one. I want to understand this more. what the begged pain is a result of wrong understanding. Is that actually the Kashai Parinam too? They are all in part of this. So worry, the pain, the lack of understanding is a reason why Kashais happen. Anger, pride, deceit, and greed makes you think that this person is hurting. But you see, when your 500,000 is not being returned by your friend, you take him to court. But if your son or daughter does not return your 500,000, do you take him to court? In other words, these are your own rag dvesh that makes you forgive the daughter and take the friend to court, you see. And so these are all of these, taking on the pain, kashais are all coming through wrong understanding only. They are all discharge effects only. It was discharge, but you see, it was discharge, but it is a kashai, an intellect that makes you see that the wrong thing has happened. In fact, nothing wrong is happening to you. It is your intellect and the ego that makes you think that something wrong is happening. Why did Gushada have to say something about Lord Mahavir, even though he was the disciple of Lord Mahavir? Because he felt as if Mahavir was blocking his own respect, you see. He was in presence of Lord Mahavir, he could not get any respect from others, and therefore he was in a jealousy mode, and therefore he was trying to feed his own kashais. And in trying to feed his own kashais, he was inviting pain, whereas the Lord was not giving him any pain to Gushada. But Gushada was fully enlightened. No, he was not fully enlightened. No, he really did not want to have any kind of gnan from Lord Mahavir. But Gushada was not fully enlightened, says Deepak Pai. This is something new that he has just said. But anyway, the scriptures say something different. Anyway, let's just carry on. When I am in jealousy and envy and competitiveness with others, but if it arises within me, how do I tackle it? If it happens within you, you can settle it. But if it, because of you, other people are in a competitive mode because of, but when you are sitting on a high horse of ego, the other person will be jealous of you. Supposing you have a good gift, a good talent, but if you have the ego of your good talent, then other people will be negative towards you because they feel that, he is arrogant. Remove your ego out of it. Then let the gift or your talent or your qualities remain. But the sense that I am superior, I am able, I know, I am something, I am excellent, etc., are all wrong adjustments, right? And those need to be dissolved, because the day your ego of pride dissolves, then the other person will not mind your talent. He will not. But you see, his accusation and his... So then the question is, why was it affecting Gushada, isn't it? No. This is Shuddha asking, but doesn't matter. So anyway. So the other person is affected because he is stung by your ego of arrogance and pride rather than your talent and your gift or ability. Dada made his ego of ability to zero when he says, whatever I have, this is a gift of grace only. It has happened in the Gnan. But we need to focus our camera on our talent and our excellence within us. But is there any associated ego sense or pride or superiority or hurt because of this to others? Then if there is, then we need to dissolve that ego completely. And leave the excellence and the good abilities as they are. But if anyone gets hurt through our abilities, then find out if there is any kind of ego associated with it, because that is the reason for the hurt to others. But then you see the sentence of Lord Mahavir, and this is Shuddha saying, how does it affect? But then when you come to the experience that I am not hurting anyone, Then of course, when you are in the state that I am not hurting anyone, I am the ocean of bliss, then no one will be hurt by you, because you are prevailing as the Atma, you are prevailing as the soul, you are prevailing as the Rainazila in a body, you see. So this is in other words, then if you are prevailing like Lord Mahavir, or if you are prevailing as God himself, and the other person gets hurt by you, or then he is begging the food, pain, and you know, you are not hurtful at all. He is kind of begging the pain. There is nothing that you are responsible for. It happens. The ability to do something, is there. But sometimes, when the work is not completed, then there is an internal suffocation too, because you believe that you could do it, but now you cannot do it. So there are dual aspects of this ability of excellence. If you are good at something, you see, if you are able to accomplish it, then you will feel good. But then otherwise, if you can't do it, then what should I do? Then he says, why don't you see what happens? Now she is taking Deepak Bhai to a lower level of satsang here, because Deepak Bhai is now focusing on this Avyabhat Swarup, but her Q&A is taking her in a lower level, because we are at the top level of understanding here. But anyway, let us not define anything negative. This is just a simple comment that I'm making. And, just adjust each other, compromise with each other, when two people are having some kind of difficulties with each other. That is not the level of the satsang that is happening here. Questioners, the question is, that no matter, we should not have any kind of hurt from anyone. This is the satsang. This is a magnificent key that no situation can cause any pain to us, and that is the beauty of this satsang right now in front of us. And the one who gives the pain, he is sowing a new karmic seed, is he not? Adarshi says, you should not be concerned with that. Okay, now we just finished reading that. Now this is a new angle of looking at it. Why not heal your own pain only is the next heading. Questioner, if the other person is suffering pain, it will pain me too, right? No. Now this is, if you feel the pain because the other person is feeling the pain, then you should do something about it. This is a very beautiful answer. If you feel the pain because the other person is feeling the pain, then you should do something about it. But the situation cannot be remedied, and one goes around with the ego that it hurts him to see others suffer in pain. Hey you, if it hurts you, then heal his hurt. You should heal his suffering of pain to stop your pain, not to give him pleasure. We should decrease the pain of the other person for your own pleasure. Take out 10 rupees from your pocket and give it to him. You are helping him in order that you can heal your own hurt. How many such people will I give 10 rupees to? The questioner is saying. Then the other, she says, you should not calculate this with your intellect, buddhi. Once you decide to give, then you will be able to give everywhere. The one who does not want to give will not be able to give to anyone. One has all the energy and powers, but it is possible to accomplish anything, but it is not possible to have both. The pain upon seeing one suffering in pain, and the calculation of how many such people can I afford to give. Nature tells you not to exercise wrong ego unnecessarily. Oblige as much as you can, just oblige and nothing else. It is not possible for you to take away someone else's pain at all. You have enough pain of your own, so oblige everybody, do just that much. When a hungry man comes, do not think, what must be his child be going through, what must his wife be going through. If he is hungry, buy some snacks and give them to him, that is all. There is no need for you to delve deeper into it whatsoever. One's pain will only go away when he meets the Gnani Purush. Thereafter he will have pleasure even in pain. Pleasure, sukh, even in dukh. Now he is in pain, even in pleasure, you see. Questioner, I personally do not have any pain. I am not an unhappy man. Dadashi says, that is fine. But human nature is such that one feels pains upon seeing the pain of the other. That is natural. It is like this. The pains you see is your own vision, drashti. If you ask the person in pain, he'll say, all these other people are in pain. Hey, are you not in pain? He will say, I have no pain at all. So it is your vision, the way you look at things, your perception. You will know that when you ask him. So people's drashti, vision, is not correct. Questioner, that is correct for humans. It is as you are saying. But what about the suffering that the animals go through? Now he is now the level, another level. This is simple things. The other person is feeling a little bit pain. Our intellect always, feels sad when we read the newspapers of people suffering, other people tormenting them, etc. And by seeing the pains of others, there is a sense of pain that arises within you. when you see a whole bunch of, you know, you're just passing in a car, but if you see poor people around, but you see, but the name, the pity and the kindness is such that it will turn, you know, so you give a little bit in order to satisfy your own pain inside. It is because you hurt that you give something in charity. You are doing it for your own self. And the kindness and pity, etc., are those kind of qualities within human being. But the most subtle level, however, the bigger sense is, if you really can, then if you really ask him, even if you ask, see, go to the home of a beggar in India, you will find that he's sleeping soundly. He doesn't have any pain whatsoever. He appears a beggar to you and in pain because you are in the comparison mode, you see. Your intellect is showing you something else. You are. So, that is why Dada says that his vision is wrong. But even if you still think sick, then if in order to decrease your own pain, just give a little bit of money and be done with it. You'll feel better. Now the level of how, what about the suffering of the animals? Dada Shri says, what I'm saying is that the pain that the animals have is that of hunger. They do not have any other pain. The questioner, suffering from hunger is considered unbearable, is it not? And the other she says, yes, unbearable. But what can anyone do? What is the solution for that? How can we run everything for the whole world? And these animals are suffering pain, are no one but those who used to be your paternal and maternal uncles who have become animals. They have come here. They are all your close relatives, says Dada Shri. Questioner, there are many people in the world who feel that they should help the sick and the poor. All the animals that are around us, and then there are natural animals who do not come into contact with human beings. They are different. But the people in cities, in homes, the animals, they are all the pets, etc., or all relations from a previous life. There are many people in the world who feel that they should help the sick and the poor. Is that a good thing or not? Dada Shri says, yes, but that is not the case with everyone, is it? Only the one who is pleased and satisfied in every way, only he will be able to do something for the other person. Generally, one is able to do a little, but the one who is eternally happy, he can help in every way towards the pleasure of others and helping others. Questioner, the one who is in every way, eternally happy in every way, he is the only one who can really help. Such a one is enlightened, you see. Eternally happy means enlightened. Right now, with what is going on politically, one is bound to feel pain when he sees what is going on. No? Now he is now going, he's shifting topics. Now he still has to decrease his own pain. Now he's talking about pain of animals. Now he's talking about pains of politicians, you see. And you see, he's just jumping around, is he not? Says Deepak Bhai. He is sitting on the seat of I am over, I am nada, and he is complaining about other things, you see. He is getting pained by the pain of the world. That is what he is doing. So now, so it is, he is prevailing as nada and uve, is he not? Now, questioner, right now, Dada Shri, whatever is taking place over there, what does it have to do with us? All you have to know is whether you will feel hurt if someone picks your pocket when you are hurt. All you have to see is whether you will feel a lot of hurt if you are traveling in a train and someone pushes you or swears at you or curses you. Meaning, whatever is taking place over there, let it be. That is not your responsibility. Dada Shri immediately asks, does somebody curse you or some? And you say, or does is your pocket pick? When your pocket picking means it is the knot of greed, and somebody curses you, it is your knot of pride. So this is the testing. You see, Dada uses these two sets. If somebody picks your pocket, that means it is your knot of greed for money. And if somebody curses you, it is your knot of pride. You better treat me nice. You better talk nicely to me. You know who I am? I'm Uwe of Munich. Be practical in these two simple states of your own pride and all your own greed. Then you are done. You don't need to be worried about it. That is not your responsibility. For that, you should have an inner intent, bhavna, and discharge. May this not happen, and may every person in this world be happy always. It should be a collective bhavna. For whom did the Lord say to have this bhavna? It is for the one whose own pain has ceased. Kalyani bhavna, Jagat Kalyan. Such a one has this external work left to do. For all, first of all kinds of pain should have ceased first. You should be painless. You should be avyadhava. One should not be affected if someone swears at you or you're robbed. You see, so your anger, your pride and greed are gone, you see. If that is the state now, then all those external activities correct. However, there is only a certain amount of benefit in it. It is such, if you have the bhavana that let the world be happy, let the world not hurt each other, you see, let the world of one religion do not hurt the people of another religion, you see, these are the bhavanas, we have it in our, now with 9 kalam, do we not? And with all of this has been covered in the book of Seva and Parokar, you see. So Deepak Bhai is skipping now, he is going on to page 202. Ultimately help your own self. Is this self-interest or the interest of others? Deepak Bhai has skipped 4 headings now, because he had covered it in the book of Seva Parokar, you see, or you know, serving or helping others. I'm talking about feelings, he says. And so now I see people expressing their feelings outside. So I get emotional and you are beyond any feelings. So what's going on? People become emotional by expressing, supposing somebody's problems and they have got... If somebody is suffering, then we know that is the cause of effects, you see. It's the effect of causes in a previous love. So we need to pray for him, saying that let he remain in equanimity and you can also try to improve his understanding about how pleasure and pain arises in life. However, how you know good things happen to you and how bad things happen to you. If we can increase his equanimity, if we can make him remain in equanimity, then you are helping him, and that equanimity will help him make him rise in his own energies. That is what we can do for somebody who comes crying to us or suffering a lot in this world, you see. And you know, when we say, you know, if you say that you do Asim Jajakar for 1 hour, then do Aarti of Dada, then come into Satsang, and then you do read something about Dada, and sometimes come to this kind of shibirs, you see. If they have a lot of problems in life, if they've got a lot of pain in life because of their current situations in life, then this is what we give them. So this is the right vision is the most important. The right vision is the right solution. You see? And so you can, you know, like if you can pray, if you can request him to come to the shibir, then let him come, you see. And after 5 days, he himself will understand that, you know, I was unnecessarily taking on this pain. You see, this pain is the effect of my own karma and my own misunderstanding. Rather than the karma, I need to improve my own vision towards him. Anyway, you know, the nice thing, you know, when you give, you have feelings, but you do not become emotional. She is using the word for emotional. Yes, you know, it is very important. If you also kind of side with the feelings and you get overtaken by the emotions of the person that you're counseling, how are you going to help him? The right way is to understand that give him the right vision approach solution only. How can it happen that I cannot feel his pain, she says. That is, you should be in the 5 agnas, see the pure soul of the other person, and then you will be in equanimity. If you lose your equanimity, how can you help the other person that you're counseling as an apta kumari or apta putri? You see, if you understand, once you are, if you drink 4 bowls of tomato soup, then next day will you not have an upset GI system, gastrointestinal system? So what are you going to do? You know, are you going to cry with him because he also drank 4 bowls of soup? You see, that was his cause and that is his effect. You know, you can only say him, please, you know, understand. Do you understand? She did not quite get it. Supposing you ate 12 laddus, you know, 12 cheesecakes, then will you not have an upset stomach? Then you can say that, why is he eating 12 cheesecakes? 12 maybe is a very heavy word. Maybe half a dozen cheesecakes. He will have an upset stomach, will he not? So are you going to make him cry? And you're going to cry with him. Oh, you ate 6 cheesecakes. I become emotional. Oh, I'm so sorry you ate 6 cheesecakes. You see? So, okay, but tell him, you know, this afternoon, have a light breakfast. You see, eat something light for the next 2-3 days and it will all be over. You'll feel better. That is the correct sense. You know, you improved his new diet, did you not? So this is... the world is suffering its own pain. You need to concentrate on the cause, you see. And if he is a Shuddhatma, then separate it from him. That's number two. File one is having it. Bringing back into the state of the Agnas only. Do you think the doctors are crying with their patients every time they treat a patient? Okay. All right. Now, next one is this self-interest or interest of others? I'll tell you the page here. It is on page 204. Okay, is this self-interest? The ones whom our people call selfish or swarthi in the world, they are called pararthi by the Vitaraks, the enlightened Lord. Pararthi means it is for the non-self. That one keeps creating entanglements and binds horrible karma. Either one who works for the ultimate benefit of all, which is called Paramarthi, is good, or the one who is selfish, truly selfish for the self on VS capital, Swarthi is good. True selfishness for the self is good. Either Swarthi is good or Paramarthi is good. Real Swarth is good. This selfishness, Swarth, is really Pararth. This worldly selfishness is actually you're doing it for Uwe and for Nada. You're not doing it for yourself. One creates unlawful and inappropriate entanglements to get money for his wife and children, and then he leaves this world. The wife and the children will enjoy a good life from his activities, but he bound sin karma and left. So he is deserving of our compassion. How can I differentiate that which is selfish and that which is non-selfish? Miss Swarth, Dadashi says, have you ever seen a swarthy, selfish person? Dadashi says, everyone has some selfishness. No, no, questioner. Dadashi says, no, there is no swarth for the self. That is pararth. People consider pararth as swarth. Rare is the swarthy person like me, who does everything for the self and moves on. This all here is pararth. One lives for another, the non-self, the putgal. Even the hard work one does is for another, the non-self. You see? Deepak Bhai now repeating. People say, look, he cheated his older brother or younger brother and he's so selfish. But it actually, what people commonly refer to as swarth, swa is the language of illusion. Here there is no, swa means atma, swa is atma, and par means chandular, uve, nada, you see. Here there is no one, so what, by to preserve your prevailing belief that I am nada, I am uve, that is par arth, then whatever you do, it is moving in the other direction. Oh, but you see, in the view of the enlightened one, you are in pararth. Paramarth means you are actually spending your life for the welfare. Paramarth means that which moves everyone and you towards the soul only. And pararth means that moves everybody from in towards the world and towards the non-self complex only. Here there is no understanding, and that is why people regard the foreign department as the home department. Do you benefit from calling that which is foreign as home? So people believe pararth as swartha and take on all risks and liability for another. It is because of illusion that you are seeing, this is my wife and these are my children. What you are seeing, you believe to be your own because of illusion. In reality, it is not yours. Or it is also untrue that you are not yours. You see? But you see, it is yours, they are yours, but they should be yours in a dramatic, for the drama of the worldly life sense only. You should not say they are not yours in the relative. You should say, that is an inner understanding. Do you keep it dramatic? Do you not? So now this is a very, you see? And so now, you see, now is it, now those, you know, the person, you know, acquires all kinds of bad money, in other words, by doing bad deeds, and he accumulates money, and then he does it for the family, but then he goes to a bad life in the next life, you see. Because you see, you need to understand, as I said, you should understand what is really yours and just be in the Agna 5, you see, and kind of do it that way. You do not keep it dramatic, do you? In a way, everyone is an actor on the stage of the world, no? Dadashi says, yes, that is true, but they are all puzzled actors. All these entanglements are only due to that. What one believes as swarth, true selfishness is not swarth or for the purpose of the self. Swarth means the meaning of swa, the self. While remaining within the home department and believing the self to be the self, one can take the benefit of the home department. Otherwise, when one believes the foreign to be the home, I am away, then it is considered swarth or it is called pararth, you see, selfishness. The people of the world use the term insistence, agra, when they are talking about the resulting insistence that is in excess. They do not call it an insistence when it is necessary for worldly needs. The relationship between a mother and a child is based on swarth, selfishness, is it not? But it is not considered selfishness because it is a necessary result. It is not excessive. Only that which is excessive is considered selfish. In the same manner, if there is undue insistence, agraha, it is considered insistence, agraha. No one is going to have any objection to it if it is a necessary result. If we have to add a necessary ingredient to this lentil soup, would anybody object? Not everyone in this world is considered selfish or swarthy. Actually, the whole world is swarthy. But because it is in the belief, not overt, it is not considered swarth. If when it becomes excess, then it is considered swarth. But it is, what is real selfishness? It is the one where one does for the one's S capital self only. It is for the pure soul only. And it is, and that too after attaining the realization of I am pure soul. That is when the true swarth begins. Otherwise, all of this is considered pararth, for another, for the non-self. Here, through swarth, one accumulates everything and then he dies. Please explain. Swarth, pararth and paramarth more. The other, she says, is there a real selfish person in your town? Real selfish. The other questioner, we do not find the one who is truly selfish. No. They too are not truly swarthy. As long as I am over, I am Chandubhai, remains in your belief, you cannot be considered selfish or S capital selfish, swarthy person. And whatever you do, it is all parath, working and toiling for another, the non-self only. This swarth, selfishness is wrong swarth. This parath means one's life is spent for the benefit of others. Just like this incense, does it burn for its own light? It burns for others, does it not? Just like this incense, does it burn for its own light? It burns for others, does it not? It does so for the benefit of others. No, in the same way, if you live for the benefit of others, then inherent in that is your own benefit. As it is, one has to die someday. So if you try to benefit others, your own benefit is in it. And if you cause pain to others, your pain is in it. You can do as you please. So what should you do, asked Dada? Questioner, one should live only to oblige and help others. Dada Shri says, yes. You should live to oblige others. However, if you change the course of your life to do that suddenly, then there will be reactions from your past and you will become tired of them. If you live for others, your salvation and your benefit is already there. And if you live by hurting others, you will be hurt. You know, so when you give to charity, automatically at the subtle level you are getting benefit inside. And if you steal, then automatically you are being hurt inside. That is why the Dada Shri says, most important, through this mind, speech and body, let there be no pain to any living being of this universe, you see. And he says, and if it happens, it is because of the causes laid in the last life only. Nothing new is happening. So the Pratavidhi is very critical. This is a subtle science only. Outside, there is out of any gross activity at the subtle level, there is a result that is automatically happening. And you know, if you are serving the Mahatmas of Dada, automatically you are getting benefit from inside, whether you know it or not. You see, and it is in the book of helping others already. So now let us skip. Sanjay asking a question. Actually, the whole world is. So Sanjay is revisiting this whole topic now. When there are normal results, it's the excess selfishness that Dada calls it selfishness in the relative world. If you do something for to make a living for your own self and to earn money for your husband, wife, children, is it called swarth? No, that is natural. You know, it's my path. But you see, it's my wife and she is not earning, therefore I have to bring food to the table, do I not? That is not called selfishness when it is excessive, you see. you know, this, yes, there is natural selfishness in the head. That is with limited swarth. It is within boundaries. But if the wife sends everything that her husband is earning quietly to her father's home, then people will make a noise about it, because she is siphoning off what her own husband is earning to her sisters or her brothers, to her own parents. You see, that is wrong. You see, so you see, and so normality in worldly interactions is the critical thing in deciding what is selfishness versus what is truly selfishness, what is not selfishness. When you are sincere to the people that are living in your home, then there is nothing wrong with it. Next question. When somebody curses you, then your pride is not affected, and therefore there is no effect. And when your pocket is, when you sustain a loss and when your pocket is picked, then you are not affected. So his question was not very clear. These are all medicines. When you see, in the relative world, when you are not attained the soul, yes, people kind of make these adjustments that, you know, but it does not give you. Beyond this, what we have, this avya bhad swarup, I am beyond pain. This is what has been discussed. And there it ends. Then there is neither profit nor loss. Profit and loss is only in the relative, you see. You see, but you know, in the relative, in the, where the soul is, there is no profit, there is no loss. Next one, next heading. What is the goal? No. What is? Deepak Bhai is skipping again. Oh, yeah, yes. What does pararth mean? If we come back to the last paragraph, it means living for children, others in the extended family. But what do you get in return? Here one accumulates hundreds of thousands of rupees. He takes on what is not rightfully his. He works, he enjoys what is not rightfully his, and then he leaves everything for his children and passes away. That is what the world is like. That is called pararth. The exact day. On page 6, skipping. All this matter is in this. So now he is going. Money is a byproduct. Money is a byproduct. Money is a byproduct. It cannot be production. If it can be produced, then everyone would be setting up factories, and then they would get money from its production. But no, money is a byproduct. The whole world needs money. So what kind of effort should be done to receive money? This needs to be understood. Money is a byproduct, so it will automatically come from the production. It is such that it will come naturally and on its own. Instead, people have started factories of money. They have made it a production. You do not have to do anything. Only the goal needs to be changed. Once you decide that you want to serve, when you serve others, money will come to you naturally. And you see, but you know, if you look at other sense, but if you do service with the money as a goal, then you will lose the main production, which is the soul. When you serve, we are moving toward the soul. Now we are going to chapter 16, boss servant interaction. Deepak Bhai skipping. So that which liberates is true education. You have studied for so many lifetimes. The same thing is to be studied again. This little boy will become an 80-year-old man and then die. And when he comes here again in this world, he has to start the alphabets all over again. Didn't you learn all that the last life, last time? Yes, but it is forgotten. When one enters the womb of the mother, it is all forgotten, you see. Bagade, it's a play on the words, you see, because bagade means it gets spoiled. Ekdo, bagado, bagade means number two, you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, all over again, alphabets again, you see. The real education is with you, says the questioner. Dadashi says, you're right. This gnan, G capital, is the true education indeed. Once we learn it here, there is no need to go to many schools life after life. Once a certain knowledge is received from me, to many schools, in brackets, life after life, once a certain knowledge is received from me, one is free. And they will say, we will not have to be born again. We were beyond birth and death. You will not have to go through kindergarten, diapers, toilet training, nannies, etc. You see, once a certain knowledge is received from me, one is free. And what freedom, muktata, that is. You will have no superior over you anywhere. I have no superiors over me. Then it seems I alone remain as your boss. But I am like a little baby. Don't I look at that way too? Don't I appear to you that way? All are, you know, the result of this understanding and this college is that you will not have anybody above you or below you. You see? The file may have somebody above you, but you will not have anybody above you. Your own file, there may be somebody above you, but you will not have anybody above you, you know. I have no superior, then it will seems to me, but I'm like a baby, am I not? Don't I look that way? Are the attributes of flawlessness not visible? You see, you know, Jnani Purush is like a child, innocent and playful. How high is he going to raise his voice at you? There is no problem if only the Jnani is above you, Jnani Purush is above you. There is no need for concern. I do not have a boss and neither do you. In this world, mistakes, mistakes and blunders is the boss over a person and nothing else. You see, blunder means I am away and mistakes means the discharging mistakes. In this world, mistakes and blunders is the boss over a person and nothing else. Every person is in this world is independent. One is only responsible for his own actions and thus he needs to be careful before doing the work. Okay, now we're taking a break. If you need to make any announcement, please make the announcement. But now we're going to Jai Sachidanand. There's announcement. Good news. This is they're talking about the WhatsApp. Energizers, Haptasutras, etc. are available to you in the and you can much more through the WhatsApp. It's available through the WhatsApp app. The Dada Bhagwan Foundation is now arranging this WhatsApp app in a practical level in your iPhone or on your cell phone. Is all you to dial is +917939830 and you'll get it. And you know, if your name is, then you have to just. You just have to say address Chandulal. And please make sure that we will not share your cell phone number with anyone. You will get automatic Apta Sutra and other Dada material by WhatsApp in you daily. This number is +917939830955. +917939830955 and put that in your address book and then along with name you have to put your name and then you have to say Jai Sachidanand. That's all. Even Jai Sachidanand not says, just give your name only. They are collecting your cell phone information and automatically WhatsApp will send you what Dada Bhagwan organization is going to send you. Now that's a break here for you. Let's take a break. And I'm just going to save this here. So, I'm taking a break now. Says satsang will resume shortly. So, while it. We're going to sing songs.
પહોંચાડીને રહી હવે ભેખ જેલી ધોછે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહી સોભેદતા ના પાટો દુનિયાને ધરી દઈશું અભેદતા ના પાટો દુનિયાને ધરી દઈશું ધર્મોમાં ભેદભાવો મીટાવીને રહીશું ધર્મોમાં ભેદભાવો મીટાવીને રહીશું આલોક ને ત્રિલોકે ડંકો વગાડી દઈશું ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહીશું સેવાના સૌ કાર્યો અકર્તા થઈને કરશું સેવાના સૌ કાર્યો અકર્તા થઈને કરીશું લઘુતમતાથી રહીને વિશ્વે જીવી જઈશું સુરવીર તારે લાવી કર્મોનો ક્ષય કરીશું અમે ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહીશું જ્ઞાનીના શરણે રહીને સંકલ્પ એક લઈશું જ્ઞાનીના શરણે રહીને સંકલ્પ એક લઈશું શુદ્ધ બ્રહ્મચર્ય પાળી કૃપાને પાત્ર થઈશું આ ભવ અમે ઉજાડી એક અવતારી થઈશું અમે ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહીશું દાદાના મોક્ષની વાતો સૌ કોઈને કહીશું દાદાના મોક્ષની વાતો સૌ કોઈને કહીશું કેવા હતા એ નાની ઓળખાણ સૌને દઈશું નિરુમાને દીપકભાઈનું સ્વપ્ન સાકાર કરશું અમે ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહી નિરુમાનો પ્રેમ ચાખ્યો તેને નહીં ભૂલીશું નિરુમાનો પ્રેમ ચાખ્યો તેને નહીં ભૂલીશું શુદ્ધ પ્રેમની જે વ્યાખ્યા તેને તો સિદ્ધ કરીશું શુદ્ધ પ્રેમની જે વ્યાખ્યા તેને તો સિદ્ધ કરીશું નિરુમાન ઉપાડી પ્રોમિસ નિર્માનુપાળી પ્રોમિસ પ્રેમ સ્વરૂપ થઈશું અમે ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહીશું અમે ભેખ જે લીધો છે જગત કલ્યાણ કાજે ખૂણે ખૂણે બ્રહ્માંડે પહોંચાડીને રહીશું
વર્તમાને જિનેશ્વર સિમંદર સ્વામી
વર્તમાને જિનેશ્વર સિમંદર સ્વામી
સ્વનું અમી જરે તેનું નામ સ્વામી
સ્વનું અમી જરે તેનું નામ સ્વામી
નમો અરિહંતાણમ આખ સામે સિમંદર
નમો અરિહંતાણમ આખ
समे सिमंदर पूर्ण चेत वंदनाती आत्मरमण सदर
पूर्ण चैत्य वंदनाती आत्मरमण सदर
निश्चय ती नमस्कारो प्रत्यक्ष तेरा सर
निश्चय ती नमस्कारो प्रत्यक्ष तेरा सर
श्रद्धानी मूर्ति छो अरि हरा परमेश्वर
श्रद्धानी मूर्ति छो अरि हरा परमेश्वर
आणि पेरे भारत पेली परवी देहे
आणि पेरे भारत पेली परवी देहे
सजीवन तीर्थ मूर्त देह साथे विचरे
सजीवन तीर्थ मूर्त देह साथे विचरे
देह साथे आपणाती ना जवाय कई नहीं
देह साथे आपणाती ना जवाय कई नहीं
बावज पहुंची जाए दर्शन थाय अही
बावज पहुंची जाए दर्शन थाय अही
चरम देही परमाणु घूमे छे ब्रह्मांड मा
चरम देही परमाणु घूमे छे ब्रह्मांड मा
ओ चरम देही परमाणु घूमे छे ब्रह्मांड मा
चरम देही परमाणु घूमे छे ब्रह्मांड मा
तेथी लाभ लब्धि थाय सूक्ष्म संधान मा
तेथी लाभ लब्धि थाय सूक्ष्म संधान मा
भगवान जागता हालता ने चालता
भगवान जागता हालता ने चालता
आपनो कल्याण करे वात माने वात मा
आपनो कल्याण करे वात माने वात मा
सत देव सत गुरु बोले सत वाणी
सत देव सत गुरु बोले सत वाणी
सत धर्मी दर्शने रत्न त्रय लाणी
सत धर्मी दर्शने रत्न त्रय लाणी
सिद्धान मूर्ति ना दर्शन थी पुण्य फल
सिद्धान मूर्ति ना दर्शन थी पुण्य फल
हरिहन्ना दर्शने प्राप्त थाय मोक्ष फल
हरिहन्ना दर्शने प्राप्त थाय मोक्ष फल
मूर्ति पूजा तपो जपे उपयोगे आराधन
मूर्ति पूजा तपो जपे उपयोगे आराधन
जीवता तीर्थनी कीर्तनाय मोक्ष धन
जीवता तीर्थनी कीर्तनाय मोक्ष धन
देवलोकी रक्षण प्रतिष्ठित मूर्ति ने
देवलोकी रक्षण प्रतिष्ठित मूर्ति ने
तेरा सरने मंदिर पमाड़े जो कीर्ति ने
तेरा सरने मंदिर पमाड़े जो कीर्ति ने
सिमंदरी लक्ष साते नमस्कारो त्रिमंत्रो
सिमंदरी लक्ष साते नमस्कारो त्रिमंत्रो
पंच परमेष्टि पद जात माज निमंत्रो
पंच परमेष्टि पद जात माज निमंत्रो
हाजरा हजूरना दर्शन ती कल्याण
हाजरा हजूरना दर्शन ती कल्याण
मनीज पास दामा मरी जीव कल्याण
निज पस दामा मरी जीव कल्याण
मतांधोनु मारण आत्मात पामवा
मतांधोनु मारण आत्मात पामवा
श्री मंदिर संकुले मुक्ति सुख चाखवा
श्री मंदिर संकुले मुक्ति सुख चाखवा
हेल्प फुल थाय एज भगवान हाजर
हेल्प फुल थाय एज भगवान हाजर
ओ हेल्प फुल थाय एज भगवान हाजर
हेल्प फुल थाय एज भगवान
while the songs are going on, we are awaiting now. This is just a break. When a large crowd is there, the break has to be a little longer before they all come back. But this is the second session in the morning, post-break session, wherein the various chapters have been discussed in the Parayana of Aptavani 7. And now the second part on August 27th morning 2014, they are going to be dealing with questions that have been that relate to today's topic, but many questions are also lingering on from the questions of the recent Parayan of Aptavani 3 and then on the soul and the nature of the soul. So, they are now just singing. Singing Dada Bhagwan Nasim Jai Jaikar Ho. Now the Q&A session is going to start pretty soon. Instructions being announced just before the Q&A session, Dandi. Well, this is the Hindi details about this WhatsApp that you can join from Dada Bhagwan organization, wherein with WhatsApp you will get after sutras. It's a, here we go now. We have the Dani, Shruti Chandaria, Amina Makwana, Shruti. So first question from Shruti. We Rajini Mumbai. 5 or 6 announced already. Jai Sachidan. After only 3 question. It is par parinati means whatever. I wanted some qualification for English translation. Pudgal Parinati and Par Parinati, is this the same? Pudgal Parinati and Par Parinati is the same, right? No. Par Parinati and Pudgal Parinati is the same thing only. That is the non-self. The belief that I am Chetan Parinati is the Swaparinati. Atma and Swaparinati is the same, yes. That was all. Minimal our translation is correct, by the way. That's all. Let's go. Who is liable for provoking? This guy is Jai Sachidanand, Jayendra Kapadia. A million namaskar, set your feet. Maybe you gave us the gnan of Dada Bhagwan, and I feel that my life has totally changed. And now we need to, and we do the, according to your Agna, we do Pratikraman Chara with the everything properly. And with the suffering and Kashayas have decreased significantly. Occasionally there is some feeling. Occasionally there is a feeling. Now we just lost. It's buffering. Sometimes there's a little suffering from the Kashayas, he says, but nothing major. Is most of it is an excellent. Initializing, it's not becoming large. Let's see what's happening. and then I want to have a quick moksh. Do not be so worried about an early moksh now, you see. Now you know, when you get the food, sometimes do you get, not get different times only, so, but you get the food, right? So you got the food. So in the same way, when we go to the Lord, moksha will happen. First we will have absolute enlightenment, and then the body will go away. But you see, there is no hurry. You will get it. Next one. Instead of Param Vinay, absolute self of the Gnani, I have been openly oppositional to Gnani Purush Dadashri as well as Niruma. You know, they call themselves God. Look at him. He thought. When I saw Niruma on TV, I also initially was very negative towards Niruma also. But later on, and then they talked about the Gnan, then I... But my crazy ego was continuing to see mistakes of Niruma as well as Dadashri. And I had all kinds of errors within me. And then I started comparing that you with Niruma. At that time I said that, at that time, in those days, and so in other words, I am worst of all the human beings here, because I have totally been in opposition of all of you, and I always felt that I was something. And I had so many mistakes within myself, and I had so much more within me, illusory attachment. I was scornful and tortured, and I was very willful, and I am very willful, etc. Every money, sex, everything I wanted. And I was always for everything. And then after Gnan, I made it even worse. Then I got depressed. My moh was not satisfied, and therefore I became angry with myself only. Then you did your siddhi, and then you gave me the injury. Then I wanted to change this ego. I want to straighten this ego nonsense that is going on within me. I could not understand the Agna, I could not understand Gnan. For 20 years this has not improved, then what's going to happen to me? And in front of other people, I had all the kashayas that were fully blown. You know, kashayas and sexuality, there's so much going on within me that I simply... And then you said that because you received a diamond without any effort, you have no appreciation of it. But I was not good either to my father or to my husband. I could not take, I have a crazy ego only, and I cannot remember anything. Let's see. And you know, I was so lost that I was so emotional that I would not even know when to get down when that my station comes, you see. And then I'm totally in a female body and in sexuality only, you see. So, and then I was constantly asking for the physical support of someone, and that I'll be left off. I was so fearful that, and if somebody else gets respected, then I get very much jealous and then everybody said that this woman is crazy, then I would get depressed, and people will say, then somebody says hi to me, I get elevated. And so I'm totally, I want to come back. You told me to Samaik, so then I don't have the heart, I don't even have that. But the two hearts, women are supposed to have two hearts, and so I don't have any repentance. But you are the manifest God, please. But why don't you clear it all for me? Because please do something for me. Okay, so come to this satsang now. Are you feeling blissful? But I am in severe fear. But are you not better now? But no. But this is the right path. Whether you feel it or not, this is the right path. Here in satsang, the ego and the intellect will kind of do not have too much stress. Do not continue negative only, because otherwise you will look barren. You should get out of this negative. Slowly, you see, you throw out the dirt and only the wheat will remain. You see, just take off and do the Asimje Jekar, Aarti, etc. Do you understand? But Pujya Shri, she says, but Pujya Shri, what will I do? No, start with Asim Jajakar and Aarti, she says. Will I be able to happen for me? Yes, for sure. Are you doing some samayiks? Yes, I am doing the samayiks. So slowly with samayiks, the energies will arise. Jai Sachidanam. Next one, Meena Makwani. My million namaskars to Pujya Shri. The awareness of separation that you are talking about, but file 1 had an attack of paralysis, they're called a stroke in youth, but I was aware during this time only. But when you do the vidhi, I felt that I'm totally separate. Is that the... Yes, it is experience of the self only. You should keep it separate only. And when you kept it separate, but again I have become mixed. It is the filth stalk, and just keep the filth stalk separate and do not hurt anyone. If you do hurt anyone, do pratikraman. But when you did the vidhi for me, I got separated. She keeps on repeating it. I was 11 days in the hospital with a stroke, paralysis, most likely. And so, and then after 11 days, my toe could move, you see. So it was your vidhi that helped me. Usually strokes in youth recover very well, by the way, Shuddha speaking. Doctor says that you might need oxygen, etc., because you are having difficulty. But no, your vidhi, for 10 days Dada was present for me, and whenever I look, I would see Dada only. And so this is very good, says Deepak Bhai. Now move on, let's go. Next one, Himanshu Shah. Nirmal. Dinesh Vania. Do you want to say something? What? Whenever we see you are in mood, in good mood. Yes, I have to say, I mean in good mood for sure. Dadashri says, pain is only for the one who begs for pain. I don't beg anyway. There is no situation in this world that can make you bring you in pains. But if you beg for pain, you will be in pain. When I do darshan of Simandar, Dada and you, I want your darshan too. Let me see you in all the Ataputras. Let me see Aniruma in them also. That's good. Please grant me the energy to be in Brahmacharya. Next one. Yes, says Deepak Goyal. Anita Gohil. Dinesh Bhai from Vijay Kamdar, Borivali. Jai Sachidanand, million namaskars to you. I have a tough time asking this question, but I hope I will get an answer. In the question, we call the self indestructible, and the Pudgal part is destructible. When the Pudgal gets complete, goes away, then when there is Keval Gnan, there is moksha, final moksha. After Keval Gnan, absolute enlightenment, there is no reaction of the soul. Then there is no role of the self as capital. In which way can the soul be called eternal and indestructible? And even in after Gnan, the self does not do anything. I don't know when it goes into the Sri Kshetra, I do not know its indestructible nature. When you go there, you will understand it. The simplest answer is that when you go there, you will understand it. In the 6 to 8 years of satsang that I am here, this question, I have difficulty with this. I have some fundamental questions, but I want a solution. You say that which is eternal, it is a matter is eternal, its quality is eternal, and its phases are destructible. In the Siddha Kshetra, it sees the scenes of the entire universe, but it is the quality of knowing and seeing is there. But through the knowing, because of the continuous knowing and seeing, there is infinite bliss only, that is all. There is no change, nothing. That which is eternal will always, there are 6 eternal elements in this world. Everything else, whatever you see is all changing. It is all situations and circumstances. But behind those circumstances, there are eternal elements and they never change. Because of the imagination quality of the S capital self, there are all of this that you see. What is the kalp shakti, the energy of imagination of the soul? You see, if the soul, the gold can be malleable, gold is gold only, but that is a quality, you see. That is why gold is flexible and that is why you can make a ring or a necklace out of it. It is because that is why, in the same way, because the soul tends to imagine things, that is why all these vikalps have arises. Vikalp means I am over. You see, there are a lot of things that are happening to file one. You are supposed to know about it. That is all. Next one. There's Anita Gohil. I have a question regarding pride. I am so in wonder about Dada that I got the answer. The negativity is coming about others because I wanted to feed my own pride only, and therefore I want to keep it separate. Yes, by keeping it separate, the knot of pride will go away. Yes, it will go away. 5 agnas is most important. And then Vidhi, Vachan, Pratikraman, Samyamani are also helpful. Next one, Vijay Kamdar. I also wanted to ask, whatever question that file one has this, which I get the answer through Dadavani and also TV, do I have to come here to particularly, if the Dadavani gives me the answer, is it not good? Yes. After you have understood, then so that and then. You say, you got the solution, so then let them have it. Next one. Two days ago in the Samaik, I am very arrogant. Generally, I like to be arrogant in front of. Only at home I am arrogant with my wife. Otherwise, I don't get any opportunity to exercise my ego outside over other people. Once she served me cold tea, so then I told her, what have you bought? So I made her make another cup of tea. And then afternoon, when the vegetable was very hot, I rejected that vegetable. And so I made her do it again. This is how I torment my wife. And if she serves me a cup that is dirty, then I throw it back to wash it again. And when I come home after the office, then I have a sour face and I do my own things. I don't talk to her. And then and she will know that I'm upset with her. Is she here? She's not here. That is why I'm saying all of these things. She is not here, that is why I am saying all of these things. Deepak Bhai asked her, is she here? Everybody is laughing. So all of these things are happening between me and my wife. At least opening, yes. You know, there is nothing wrong in accepting your mistakes. And then when she makes the hot tea in the morning, then she says, I'm not going to give you in a cup. Open your mouth, I'm going to pour it in your mouth only. That's how she will say. You want hot tea? I'm going to pour it in your mouth directly. And so when I told her to put more salt and spices, they said, you got blood pressure, look what's going to happen. You got acidity, eat what I'm giving you. Yes. But this is all my mistakes only. I don't exercise my ego anywhere else. Why should I exercise my ego in front of my wife? And so I want more. 2 days ago, I enjoyed Dimple Bhai's talk a lot because it came from the heart about not hurting anyone. It was excellent. And so I'm very helpful for, I got inspired by what he said. Okay, Sachidan, next one. Jai Shri Jai Shah Anand. Arvind Gopal and then Kundan Ben Patel. Jai Sachidanand. With reference to the use and abuse of authority, I want to discuss. One day it happened that after Aarti, when I do event, want to do the Samayik, in the Samayik, then I felt that it was, I just touched it superficially early. I could not do the full Samayik. So I did the Samayik again. The abuse of authority is because of the status, and then also there is the misuse of authority in relationships with a wife, or if I am my husband, then I have an authority over my wife, and then I have a son-in-law, so that I expect something, and then, you know, and then whenever I am a father, I am an uncle, I use this abuse of authority because I am an uncle. And then I went deeper into it. And then I tend to when I abuse those below me, those below me also kind of perpetuate that authority of the self. In this whole world, in all of this, kashayas are associated. At the bottom of all kashayas, there is authority, the sense that I am something. You see, when I suppress the one below me, he suppresses the one below him, etc. So when we do the samayik, if I am not willful, when I do anger, samayik, everywhere, it's all behind, at the deep below, this is a sense of satta or authority only. That I am something. The moment you become aware, of course, that is this authority, is it not? So the everywhere, everyone is misusing their authority only, is it not? How can we become aware of this satta or this authority that we say many times it's not mine, but there are a lot of places where our satta or there is this sense that I am something. I'm a husband, therefore how can I? How can I become free from this sense? Deepak Bhai says, who is the owner of satta? Ego. This is ego is needs to get broken. I am not this thing. I am pure soul. I am not Uwe. You become free from it. I am not the husband. Whatever is in scientific circumstantial evidences, let me settle with equanimity. He says, you know, then when I tell the wife to heat up the water, she will say, here, open your mouth, I'll pour it in your mouth. You see, therefore, you should know that the moment you hurt somebody, there will be a reaction of her ego too, or his ego too. So the ego point through five agnas is the only way to really move away from Uva and his ego reactions. I am pure soul, I am... And so that way the abuse of authority will go away. And Vyavasthit will also accept that whatever has been Sahaj Mila Sodhu Barabar, whatever has been attained naturally is like milk. What you ask for is like it turns into water, and what you grab it turns into blood. So this is the awareness is what is going to let you rise up. Yes, of course, the AA, BB, five agnas, all of those are the best ones, of course. But I want some advanced awareness that then you have to have the decision that you see at the moment you have to have. That you have to make the prior decisions that whatever I get, I want to settle in equanimity. Make the decision. I do not want to find any fault with her, you see. And it's, I do not want anything out of this authority. Whatever, I will use it for the benefit of others. I will not abuse it. So if you ask for the energies for this, will it come in helpful? Yes. But more important, depending, you need to have your awareness where there is the sticky karma. You see, if it is with reference to sticky files, etc., you don't have much. If you have an issue with your father-in-law, then attack that one. If you have an issue with your file 2, the wife, then, you know, be focused on that. So apply your awareness where it is needed rather than in a bland manner everywhere, you see. Jayashree Shah is the next one. About that is Samayik on the ego. I was aware, I became aware of the hunger of the pride of the ego and the suffering because there is the hunger of pride within the ego. And then I keep on observing that wherever I have to give. When I need to praise others, I was not able to really praise others, and therefore I get a lot of. And then I have such a file. In other words, I have to. Husband is such that I have to. Just go ahead and why don't you? So if there is such a file, she doesn't name whether it is the father-in-law or the husband that he. I cannot respect the other people around me. So. And so it is my observation that I cannot respect others and therefore I have a problem with it. So make the niche. Settle the file with equanimity. You are neither to give the pride. Your hunger of pride is so much that. But if there are two hungry people come across each other, will they not grab the same food? And so therefore the ego that is hungry for pride is such that everybody will scramble for it. You see, that's just like birds that are. You know, scrambling after seeds, you see. So therefore, just say that I don't want any pride validation. I'm pure soul. I do not want my hunger for pride to be satisfied. You see, I'm not hungry. You see, so you know, just share. You know, respect others. You see, you know, I want to break the knot. So, but I don't want pride. But respect. Instead of giving respect to others, be sincere to them, towards them. See the pure soul. See the positive within them and have love with them. So then pride will go away. Don't try to give respect to others, because when you give respect to others, you are bypassing the soul. You see them as a pure soul and be kind to them. You know, do not see their mistakes. Do not have any expectations out of them. I don't want anything out of them. He's a pure soul only. And I'm just settling the file with equanimity. When I have to respect them, I see them at fault at all. No. No, see him as a pure soul. See that you have to serve. Why should I all day I'm stuck up with, why should I respect him? Try. It's a file that I need to settle with equanimity. You have bound that account in a previous life. You have selected that person in a previous life, you see. Then let him. I think he's a husband, right? He says, I need to respect him. He is your husband because that is what you asked for. In the past life, and that is why he is there with you in this whole life. But it is your own disease. Do not, you see, because you see, when you want to become free from kashais, you need to preserve him, you see, and because and it is somebody in the home only, so there is no other thing, you see. So, and so, once you decide that he is absolutely flawless, that you know, no. It's just, you know, I have to respect him. No, not that way. He's a file. I want to settle with equanimity. I want to finish the account with him. That's all. He's a pure soul only, you see. But I have to respect him. No, I have to spend my whole life with him. That's not going to work. You see? Okay, next one. Mm-hmm. Nulit Maruni, Mumbai. The awareness of separation from the subtle to the subtlest, I want to understand it. Whatever samayaks we did this time, I do know this, whatever activity is happening, it is because of the past life planning on the basis of intentions of past life, and that is why mind, intellect, ego and chit are acting. But the external activities that are happening from morning till evening, whatever activity of the mind's body, body and speech is happening, it is because of the previous knowledge only and is the result of it. But then there is some suffering, but all of this is happening, and then you know, then it is happening to me. So when we do the samayiks, then I can know that the everyday activities is the result of ignorance only, but it is my own begged pain only, you see, everyday activity. But now there is no suffering at all. I can keep it separate, and I know that what Navin is doing, that where is his chest, and you know, again and again he is doing this to this, and he is doing this, what he is saying to others. I all day there is focus on what Navin is doing, but then I make him do the samayik. Why did you do this thing? Why did you do the ego index? Why did you talk like this? Why did you? What is the underlying opinion about it? And analysis. Then I go up, what was the opinion? And then I clear out the opinion behind that person, and then there is no suffering. But then what is the next purusharth? The next purusharth is, yeah, you have this from childhood up until now, just keep on see rag, vesh or moh, which look at, he says the sexual knot and the pride is very big. Everybody has got the same big two knots, right? Sex and pride, right? And so you have to find out which branch it is of this. Is it superiority? I'm correct. I want to appear good in front of other people. Find out what it is, if it's not. And then with those people, then we know where the expresses, find out the very interfered, and then clear it off. And in all of this, you know, what will I do so that it all goes away? No. Improve the present. When the file one has free time, then clear off the old accounts. That's all. And then focus on everything, what has happened all day long, what has happened, and then become the knower and seer of the anger, greed of kashayas, as well as man, buddhi, chitta, hankar, mind, ego, intellect and chit, you know. And then find out where his vision gets develops in a sexual look, where he wants to have some sexual satisfaction by looking at women, etc. But then whatever, you know, in satsang, there is so many different kinds of seva and service has been developed through Mahatmas. And then there was this thing, before I used to like to sit up front, but then, and then we used to tell somebody to preserve my attack, but you see, but we should remain in the Gnan Mandir of Moksha rather than trying to preserve our seat here. You know, isn't this deceit that I want to sit in front of you? Isn't that a deception? And I have done all of those kind of mistakes that I wanted to be in front because I want to show off. But right now you are not trying to save. But I am happy wherever I sit. Wherever see, in the Adashri, you have said that wherever you sit, you know, my vision is on you. Therefore, I am content wherever I am sitting. I am highly grateful to you and Niruma and Aptaputras of Niruma and Niruma. I have to do a lot. And when the file comes, today Deepak Bhai made them understand, Niruma explained such beautifully. And at that time, why do you say, because I used to say, Dada, I said that it is Dada's speech. But then when I analyzed it, it was because, yes. This is the origin. That I all want to preserve Dada's Vani, because when I praise, when my wife praises your speech or Niruma's speech, I say that is actually Dada speaking. I should say that even if the Aptaputra is speaking, even if Deepak Bhai is speaking, I should just say that Dada himself is speaking through all of this. And today we have so much wonder and praise for you, but you have to keep such an awareness. So no. You go ahead and praise me, and you will be there. If you praise me, you will progress higher, was the answer. If you praise me, you will progress higher, was the answer. the question was, do we not have to set a higher level of awareness when we praise you? And so he immediately put the Deepak Bhai down by saying that by me praising you, I mean, you get sucked up to the question of pride. But Deepak Bhai says, no, praise me and you will raise higher. So now the next question from this lady. It's only on pride only. She says that everywhere she is seeking the validation of her own pride only. She wants to feed her own pride, kashai only. She's hungry for pride only. Convert it into satsang. Convert it into, now come it into matters of satsang only. You have to be present in satsang and seva at the right time. But because you come late, she deliberately comes late in order to be noticed, you see. So don't try to do this sort of things, you see. Be aware inside that, what is your goal? Do you want to feed the pride or do you want to be the self? Do you want to feed the pride or do you want to be the self? Next one, Raghuvirish Rani, some more being asked. And Falguni Javeri. Mahesh Manali, Rajkot. Jai Sachidanand, Raghuviri Ishram. I am pure soul and I am not the doer. That awareness, what should I do for that? Vyavasthita is the doer. I know that, but even then, why do I feel the load of doership? Why do I not get the bliss of the eyes? When I am doing it, is that part of pride? The sense that I am doing it, is that part of pride? You just have the conviction only, but still there is a discharge ego too. Because some people, when they say that I have to follow the agnas, and they get into the doership of the agnas and the load of the agnas, slowly you will become natural. There is nothing to be done. This is all understanding only, you see. That knowledge, that conduct which hurts others should not be there, as explained by that young man with the glasses only just a while ago. You see, you should not hurt anyone. The doership will give you hurt. Understand that this is wrong conduct. Let it be helpful to others only. Then, you see, that is all. You will not have any load. And the prakriti, the junk of prakriti will decrease. Settling a file with Nikwalimiti, he says, then I have noted that I feel him at... I feel him at fault because I see him as the doer. He is the non-doer, but you are calling him as the doer. It is his filth talk that is coming out. If he is vomiting, would you ever call? If you ever blame him, he is blaming. This is what he ate in the last life, and therefore it is vomiting with those words, hurtful things now. But you see, you have to set it all. You have received this magnificent gnan without settling any karma, you see. And therefore, you see, as it unfolds, you have to have the awareness of the understanding of the self only. But my own sense of doership is not going away. How will I understand the other is not a non-doer? You have to separate first. But you see, if you think that you are the doer, if one evidence is lacking, will you be able to do anything? You see? If there is one wrong belief that I am doing, there is the intellect has all kinds of answers in what way I am the doer. You know, I did this, but that whatever the intellect has multiplied has to be divided with by that I am not the doer through the knowledge of pragna only. You see, that who am I? Who is the doer? You know, I raised this home. I made them understand. I set them all in life. Whenever they had problems, I gave them the solutions. I was the one who did it. But the intellect has got a lot of answers and evidence is saying that I did it, I was the one who did it. And then you have to talk to this as, did you not screw up the other day? Did you not spoil the work the other day? You know, so out of the 10 acts, you know, what about the 2 acts that you totally spoiled, the 2 activity and the 2 work that you could not do? That means you are not the doer. If you are the doer, it will be all perfectly done every time, right? And therefore you say that it happened because of me. Then what about the role of the other people, you see? Then who? In this, you see, when it gets spoiled, he does not say that I spoiled it. He blames others, you see. So what's going to happen? So he said, if you were the doer, then it did well because of circumstances, and it did not do well because of circumstances too. It did not happen because of circumstances, and it happened because of circumstances. You are not the doer. Then you see, you should not never say. Then he says yes. What it some improves sometimes, and sometimes it worsens too. Sometimes it does not improve, and so then the intellect will slowly understand. Do you understand? This is important. Now, next one, Jay Sachidana. Falguni Javeri. My question is about Vinay and Param Vinay, humility and absolute humility. We have come into this world through many knots about anger, greed, deceit, and pride, and when situations happen, then the ego really just revolts and cries very high, and during that situation, then we have said that no matter what the circumstance, we must not really miss the Vinay and the Param Vinay, the humility of the other person. But when the ego is rising very high, even we try to make it understand, even it understands that this is wrong, even then one vomits out. And once the vomiting happens, then later on there is a lot of repentance afterwards. But during that session, the ego is the ego willing to understand during the time of vomiting, or does it? You know, so then ego rejects this gnana at that time. So what is happening? How should I quieten the day? No, don't try to quieten the ego at that time. Will you be able to make the drunk person listen at all? It's only when his alcohol comes down, his ego intoxication comes down. That is when, after a while, that is when you talk to the ego, you see. Not during the height of the revolt or at the height of the acute reaction. Not during the height of the acute reaction, you see, when it is subsided. This is like the filled stock, you see, some of it will come out with force, and then some of it, at that time, the awareness will not be there, you see. But he is not willing to listen to to Gnan only, but when it quietens down, then you have to sit down and wipe out. Therefore, you have to sit in 1 hour of Samayik. When you sit in 1 hour Samayik, why did I hurt that person by trying to exercise my arrogance? And so find out where the profit was and where the loss was. Find out how much you lost in the matters of the soul and how much you lost by with those kashais, you see. So when she is sitting, you know, when the force of the undischarging karma is less, that is when you have to sit down in Samayik. And then strengthen your nischaya magnificently, and then make her do a strong pratikraman and a strong pratyakhyan that it must not happen again. I don't want to hurt anyone, and my signature is not there for anyone when this happens. It is through this para and parushans and all of these things. These are all circumstances where this energy of the self will increase magnificently for you. Okay, Jai Sachidana. A good question and answer there. Now next one, Mahesh. Dada, Niruma, and you, there is some one common thread that I have been able to see, that Dada used to say, don't worry about it, just take it short, keep it short, you don't want to hurt anyone, even to the slice. Niruma, all over her, through in every fiber of her body, did not want to hurt anyone. Niruma, and this is exactly what you're saying. Whenever somebody says, your first thing is, do not hurt anyone. Just do this much. Forget about everything else. Stop hurting anyone. This is gnan. This is knowledge. But how can I... This is knowledge, gnan. How can I understand this as vignan, the science on autopilot? And Dada does not talk about moksha and ultimate mistake. He will just say, if you do this, you will have this. This will happen. If you do this, what is the result of this? I want to know the result, and I want to understand the vignan behind this. Deepak Bhai says, if you talk to Mahesh, that you do not hurt. If you talk to Uwe, do not hurt anyone, the vignan begins. If the separation is the vignan, the separation of the line of demarcation is the science in operation. Do you think the soul has to understand about not hurting anyone? It is only Mahesh who will have to stop hurting others, you know. So you have to tell Mahesh, Mahesh, separate from Uwe and say, Uwe, stop hurting anyone. The doer is always separate from the knower. You are the knower, you are not the doer. You understand? And okay. Oh, this is Vignan. Vignan means the one who... Vignan means the one who is never doing anything. Why does he need to really correct anything? The self is never the doer, so he doesn't need to correct anything. The one who does it has to correct. That is the science, you see. You see, and you know, if there is a lot of junk, will you be able to see the junk and garbage without the light being on in the room? The light has to be on in the room. Once the light is on, then automatically you'll know where to clean it. That is the science, you see. You see, the light is the knowledge, and you see, the ego is the cleaner of the dirt, the getting rid of the garbage outside the house, you see. And then whatever has happened is the lottery, you see. When you know, understand that your understanding is wrong, that is called gnan, knowledge. I don't want to hurt anyone. And then Wait, said Deepak Bhai. If I don't hurt anyone, the hurt pain will not come to me. No. Yeah, but, never say, Nathanathi, don't say I'm not giving hurt to another. In other words, I do not beg anybody's pain, you see. You know, Vorilevu means, you know, you take a bow like a monk and say, please give me some food. I do not accept anybody's pain, and therefore I am beyond pain. Not that... You know, he said, it's not that you give anybody any pain, because Mahesh Bhai certainly, if you are Mahesh Bhai, then you, Mahesh Bhai, is going to give pain, right? But you, awakened one, the Y capital, never gives anyone any pain. Depends on where you are. If you believe you are giving anybody pain, then you are giving other people pain. But if you do not give, if you do not take anybody's pain, then you will not give anybody's pain. You told Dimple Bhai in such an intimate manner that make sure that you do not hurt anyone. And Deepak Bhai was, Dimple hung on to that sincerely, and therefore, you did not bless Dimple Bhai. You just gave him the exact answers of how to proceed further. And you see, what we say that if you are uncomfortable in a room, then you know, don't try to turn the fan, just push the switch. The right switch is be in the five agnas and remain separate. Now let us do the samayik now. The samayik will come, the questions will give later on. Let us do samayik now. Vore, the samayik is in vore, to beg for pain. You know, people beg for pain and pleasure. Yes, sir. Yes. You see, the one who begs is called a beggar, is he not? Never beg for any pain. Are you going to beg for? You are the master, the emperor and the ocean of bliss. Why do you beg pain? It is nothing but imaginary pain, is it not? You know, look, he just said this, look what he's doing. You see, your camera is focused on somebody else. Look, he's saying negative things about me. Look, he is criticizing me. Look, he does not appreciate me. You see, you are in so many ways, you have wrong belief of pain, what's or not, you see. Dada says, you know, if the person says, come at noon, you know, he says, why did you call me so early? I eat at 1 o'clock. Now, you see, if you do not beg for pain, the pain will not come, you know. Whatever has happened is correct and vyavasthit, then there is no pain is there, you see. So, this we need to change internally, see. If somebody says something hurtful, if you do not receive those words, but you convert it into positively, that it is good for you. But if you do not really receive it at all, then you are avyabhad, are you not? You know, then he is just throwing his words in the air, but your ears pick it up. One day, we were in a train. You know, somebody was cursing me in English and I kept on looking. Everybody says, Deepak Bhai is just one. Deepak Bhai did not understand that that person was cursing me in English. But other people were very upset that they are cursing Deepak Bhai. But I was looking, you see, and they said, Deepak Bhai, you were so equanimous, you were like Buddha. But in fact, Deepak did not understand. Out of ignorance also, I did not know, and I know I was not at all touched. But once we have the understand, but once you understand that he's cursing you, then somebody says, you are akarmi. That means, Dadashri says, you are correct. Akarmi is a curse in India, But you know, actually, yes, you're right. I am beyond karma. Karma does not touch me. You see, but we can convert what he's saying to us with the right vision. You see, now the other person is in pain in his own ways. You know, but if you do not accept that pain, if you do not beg that pain, if you do not keep it in your plate, then it will not affect you. If somebody says you do this much, what he calls me inferior, he gives me such a stupid job. He could have asked some other person to do it. This is all your pride. You see, you get upset because you see that he's suppressing me. He's trying to get me under his control. He's trying to do. So we are using our excess intellect, and therefore you are taking on pain. That person, he may just have said, "Yo, will you do this for me, please?" You see, we just have to settle the file with equanimity. But the intellect will not let you rest in peace. The intellect will measure what he said. Oh, he's trying to put me down. He thinks I'm going to be his slave, huh? You think I'm going to do all of these things for him? So the intellect is the one that actually begs for all of this pain from everywhere. You see, supposing there was a meeting that was happening of six people, and if you were not called, he says, "Oh, I was not called." You see, so whatever's happened, don't you think it happens sometimes? Maybe they forgot to allow you to call you, because if you have the sense of pride that I'm something, then you will be hurt. Oh, I was not included in the meeting. But if you go to the meeting like this, and if you have got a knot of pride there, then people will say, "I don't want this guy here. He's constantly wanting his ego to be nourished in this meeting, whereas we are here to do some important task only." So we take on pain when it is not necessary. We beg for pain. You see, we beg at and feed our beg for pain, and then we feed our own kashais with it. You see. You say, "Am I a paid servant?" You see, we first of all have to understand our own intellect. Why are you suffering? We should tell the intellect of who you are suffering, therefore you are at fault. I'm not, you know, you should accept it. So we should talk to Uwe from inside. We should talk to Nada and Katya from inside. But if we break them down, you see, so if we kill our own intellect, then nobody will hurt us, right? So in every matter, we need to tackle our own intellect by we have to. Today we are going to find a samayik, that is it the people have giving us, or are the people really hurting us, or am I taking up myself and I am magnifying it myself? I am begging it and I am magnifying it. It's not I am the one who is begging it and taking it on. I am believing it. There might be two or four times when you know you yourself have been hurtful in this life to them, so then it comes back to you again, you see. And so, you see, because we have been insistent, we have been inflexible, we have been arrogant, then the reactions are coming to us. So, in this way, if you analyze it, most people are not out there to hurt you, but we kind of magnify it unnecessarily, we kind of take it on ourselves. So, let us look at in life where there has been suffering, let us check the sufferings. Did the people give it to us, or did we create it? When we feel insulted, then there is pain. When the respect we get is less than what we expect, then we feel pain. The other person, the one who is insulting, is not insulting you. He is insulting the one who is the beggar and the hungry one inside you. He is insulting the one who is hungry, the hungry ego inside, and he is beneficial to you. But you take it on by saying that he hurt me, he didn't respect me, he didn't call me in the meeting, etc. So if you understand, then you will understand that there is no pain at all in here, and therefore we need to. And you know, if they are respecting, calling that man in front, giving him all the good things, then you know that means your own imaginations take hold, and he says, "Oh, he doesn't care for me. He doesn't understand how good I am, etc., etc." So this is called jate varilidu. In other words, you have taken on the pain yourself only. And so tomorrow, therefore, you know, negativity starts automatically and you hurt. We create more hurt because of this serious issue of man mostly, but many times we are magnifying it through our own imaginations only. Yes, admittedly, if your tooth is aching, if your back is aching, your body is aching, it's a different kind of pain, you see. That is a physical pain, you see, but the mental pains is nothing but pure neurosis, nothing but invited pain only. It is nothing but junk. It doesn't need to be there. It doesn't have any value. It doesn't have any substance. After awakening, there should not be any mental pain at all. There should not be any verbal pain at all. People speaking, yes, the physical pain we will settle with equanimity, but you should not be suffering any mental pain You should not be suffering any pain through words at all of someone or anyone in this world. So let us look at this in the Samayik today, that how, in what way and through what misunderstanding do we magnify pain, and then we also accuse the other person, not only after we beg for it, but then we blame the other person that I am unhappy because you are like this way, you are not this way, you are not doing this way, you know, you are not behaving this way, you know, so we magnify the pain not only for ourselves, but we also are in a constant fight mode with the close file around us, you see. Nada says that clearly. Nada says that we never take any pain, we do not beg for any pain, therefore we never give any pain. So no, because we do not take any pain from anyone, nobody gives us any pain. But really we are the ones, and not only that, you know, even if he is eating in his plate, we grab from his plate, we take the pain, you know, give it, and we say, this is my pain, you see. You should understand the nature of the pain, because this is very important. I have experienced that if I become adjust in every matters, that people will say that, you know, why is he adjusting? But if I adjust, then I am in bliss only, am I not? I am in harmony. Because in all my life circumstances, I always adjusted to everything. I always applied Dada's Gnan every day, and I made my own adjustments, and therefore I had no pain whatsoever. And nobody was in pain because of me, because I adjusted to them. I made my own internal adjustment. Nobody came to me complaining about it. Nobody complained about me to anyone or to me even. But now I understand this exact method of Dada, that in any, if you have the positive adjustment in any situation, then there will be no pain whatsoever. When I make the adjustments, I also avoid clashes. Whatever situation arises, I adjust. And then if there is any effect to me, then I know that it is my own effect. These are four magnificent AABB are fantastic sentences. Then there is no pain whatsoever for me at all. AABB is the best way to remove yourself from pain. So without changing anybody outside, you see, when you make your adjustments according to your correct understanding, then there will be no pain at all. Whatever is missing within you, we have so much available, and Dada is there, and Dada's Vignan is there, you see. And through the wrong understanding can be thus removed, and the right understanding can prevail. And this is the wrong, and when the not a wrong understanding will go, then there is nothing but bliss, bliss, and bliss only. This is the scientific way to become blissful and to become free from all pains in life. Let us take that in Samayik, that where do I get take on the wrong pain of somebody? Nobody is giving a pain to me, and yet I feel pain. What's going on? I should not let that happen at all. I want to become free from that misunderstanding, you see. And let us take that in Samayik today, okay? Everybody understood, understands this? Let us do the Vidhi now. Dada Bhagwan, O Dada Bhagwan, E Shri Simandhar Swami Prabhu, dear Lord Simandhar, with the exact applied awareness of your soul in worldly interactions through any human being, any kind of worldly interaction may have happened, and in that, I, because of misunderstanding, I became a beg pain and suffered pain. But in fact, there is nobody out there to give pain to me. It is my own misunderstanding that gives me pain, and therefore I beg for pain, I magnify pain, and therefore and suffer pain. And in all those matters, let me check in Samayik, where I have begged and magnified pain, and let me look at those wrong understandings in Samayik. Let me get rid of those misunderstandings, and in those situations, become free from pain in those situations. Let me do such a Samayik, my Lord. For that, O Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self, grant me absolute energy. I surrender the mind, speech, body, all illusions associated with my name, bhav karma, charge karma, द्रव्य कर्म, सटल डिस्चार्ज कर्म, येलो ग्लासेस, नो कर्म, ग्रोस डिस्चार्ज कर्म. हे दादा भगवान, ओ एब्सोल्यूट सेल्फ विद इन मी, यू आर द मैनिफेस्ट एब्सोल्यूट सेल्फ विद इन मी, यू आर द परमात्मा विद इन मी, द लॉर्ड गॉड विद इन मी, एंड इट इज योर डिवाइन फीट आई एम सरेंडरिंग ऑल दीज टू यू. शुद्धात्मा छू, 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 शुद्धात्मा छू. जय सच्चिदानंद, जय सच्चिदानंद. गो डीप एंड डू अ ब्यूटिफुल सामायिक. दिस इज सच एन एक्सलेंट सामायिक दैट दैट इट कैन कीप यू इन ब्लिस ऑल योर लाइफ. दिस इनवाइटेड पेन्स एंड बैक पेन्स, इफ यू कैन बी फ्री फ्रॉम देम, देन यू विल बी इटर्नली ब्लिसफुल. दिस सो गो वेरी डीप इन टू दिस, दैट फाइंड आउट दैट ऑल पेन्स आर द वंस दैट आई हैव बैक्ड ओनली. And I want to become free from it. This is a magnificent samayik. I do not want to, so that no pain will touch you, no words will touch you, no mental difficulties will touch you. You say whatever misunderstanding is remaining in the current life, in the current state, get rid of it through this particular awareness and samayik. Do a beautiful samayik, beautiful gift from our Gnani. Jai Sachidanand, Shuddhatma Bhagwan. Jai Sachidanand. And let us save this.